5 tips to perform a successful professional fitting. And first of all, my dears, I want to share with you a situation from very beginning of my sewing career. So many years ago, when I just started making clothing for customers, I had a customer, she came to make a dress. And we had the fitting, and I put all necessary marks on her dress, like darts, constructive lines, neck hole, armholes, lengths. Everything was done very good. I was so happy. And when she came to pick up the order, she put it on, and it was a complete disaster. The dress was looking like from a different person, from a different body shape. So after that, I was always following necessary steps to perform a correct fitting. And I want to share these tips with you also, so you will be always able to avoid the mistakes that are very common for people who are just learning to sew or who already have some sewing experience. So let's begin. And first of all, it's a bra. So ask your female customers to come for a fitting with the same type of the bra that they will be using under the garment that you are making. Of course, it's very important if you're making dresses, blouses, shirts, vests, tunics, jackets. It will not be such as important if you're making coat, because coat fabric is very thick, much thicker than even suit fabric. So it will not be having such a big effect on a coat. And if you're looking on a, for example, push-up type of bra, like sport type of a bra, they will have totally different position, like, you know, on your body, and they will have different distance between the center of the breast, the heights of the breast will be different. So if you're talking about position of the darts here and darts, the vertical darts over here, they will be moving depending on the bra you are using under the garment. Okay, so be careful with that. The second very important thing, it's a shoes. And we are not talking about the style of the shoes or kind of the shoes, but the size of the heels is very important. And if you're marking the length of the pants, the bottom line of the pants, you need to wear the same size of the heels that this pants will be using with. And if you're thinking that, okay, I will mark it just to the floor level, for example, without any shoes, and this will be kind of universal length of the pants. No, most of the time it will be short. So don't do it. If you don't have any shoes to try this pants with, at least make it 1.5 centimeter longer than a floor level. Because while wearing the pants tends to shrink around like knee area, it will be a little bit shorter. So, but for the best result, please wear shoes. This will be much better. This if you're talking about pants. But if you're talking about making a dress, for example, or skirt, especially if you are making form-fitted dress, very important to wear shoes. Why? Because when we are standing like on a flat, for example, in the floor, our posture is like, you know, normal, like that kind of, we are just standing normally. But if we are wearing heels, our posture tends to change. What's happening? Our shoulders most of the time goes a little bit like, you know, back to the back, a little bit more open. Our spine like kind of curved in, you know, forward, and everything all in the body, the balance of the body changing. So it's very important to make a fitting, especially with the darts, if you're making the very like exactly like, you know, form-fitted dress or skirt, to wear heels. The third tip, ask your customer to stand in a normal their position, in a normal posture, how they usually stand, you know, because pretty often they're trying to do like that. You start doing fitting, they're standing normally, and after they do like that, you know, they're trying to be more like kind of straight for a fitting. And if you are making garment with a sleeve, for example, like let's say you're making jacket and you're trying to fit the sleeve, look what's happened. You're standing like that. And this, you see how much change the center of the sleeve. It's entire inch between this position and this. And also the position of the sleeve will be, you know, moving around that. So ask them to stay normally how they usually stand. Because this is, will be affecting not only shoulder position, but also the center between the center of the breast line and shoulder, the length of the back, the center of the back also will be changing to that. So, and also control it during a fitting, because every 5-10 minutes they tend to go like that, or they tend to go like that. So you need to control, you need to see how customer usually hold their kind of body, their balance of their body, and then you can see during a fitting if they're changing or not. So that's, you need to pay attention. Tip number four, ask your customers not to help you. I know it sounds silly, but pretty often customers trying to help a dressmaker while fitting. For example, you're making a dress or you're making a jacket, any garment with a sleeve, and you are trying to pin a sleeve to the armhole during a fitting, customer can do like that, kind of shifting a shoulder towards you. Or for example, you're making a dress and during a fitting, you are attaching, you are pinning a skirt to the top of the dress, forming the waistline. The customer also can do like that, can move their waist or hip area towards you. Another very common thing, if you're marking the bottom line from the floor, like, you know, even distance, they can also all start looking down where you're marking, so all balance of the dress or skirt is changing. Another very common, they can start moving, if you, even if you do not ask them, kind of helping you. So I always tell my customers, please, your best help is not trying to help. And, you know, different customers, different country, the habit is the same. It's very human, very natural. They're trying to help you with a very good intention, but it's very distracting and it's actually changing the balance of a dress or of any garment you're making. So be aware of it and always correct your customer when they're trying to do it. Okay, and tip number five, the last one, make sure that your customer is in a good mood. Make sure that they're having enough break time during a fitting if they need, or even before fitting. For example, if your customer coming from the long working day, they're tired, or they're coming during a day but they're looking not good, you see there's something emotional not good, let them sit. Offer them water, offer them tea, give them this 10-15 minutes to have a break. Talk to them, say some jokes, let them look at the magazines. So help them to lift their energy up, emotional and physical. Because tired customer, it's the waste of time. I guarantee you, you will need to reschedule this fitting or you will need to have additional fitting. Because tired customer will go like that, will go like that, will not having their balance at all, but they can go like that also. They will not be participating in fitting. And you need them to be alert. For example, you need some response for them. You see, the pocket will be good located in this level and is good for the design, and but they, for example, like it to be a little bit higher. You need to be able to communicate with them. They need to be able to answer questions and to see actually where they want it. So put some effort in this. If you see that they need some help, help them. Sometimes work of a dressmaker, it's a little bit psychologist work. So you need to do it too. So I hope this video helped you and these tips will help you to actually be more professional in your fittings. And yeah, I wish you good luck, and please leave me a comments how you usually do your fitting, what you do for your customer to avoid some mistakes, and I will be glad to see a response from you too. So I wish you good luck with your project, good luck with your fitting, and looking forward to seeing my next video. Bye bye.